Bishop Hannington. So they could have bishops consecrated there for Uganda and the leadership and everything. But in 1961, this is when we had the first Archbishop of the Church of Uganda. So I want to thank God. This was in 1961, 16th April, the Most Reverend Dr. Leslie Brown, followed by the Most Reverend Eric Savity in 1966, followed by the Most Reverend Janan Room, 1974. And you know what happened. Followed by the Most Reverend Sylvanus Swan, also 1977. Followed by the Most Reverend Dr. Yona Okoth, in 1984. Followed by the Most Reverend Dr. Livingstone Mpalanyinkoyoyo. And I want to welcome Mama Ruth, who is here. Mama Ruth, stand up. Thank you very much. Followed by the Most Reverend Dr. Henry Luke Orombi. Followed by the Most Reverend Stanley Ndagali in 2013. He's here with us. Would you please stand up? And myself, to God be the glory. I want to appreciate the Bishop of Namirembe and also your team for receiving us very well. And all the bishops, would you please stand up? Bishops of the Church of Uganda, they are all here. May I request you to move forward because the cameras are not seeing you. At least they know people are watching. They say, oh, our bishop was also there. Bishop Regessa, Bukedi, Bishop Katumba, West Uganda, Masaka, Bishop Bagamuhunda from Chigezi, Bishop Zoreka from Kinkizi, Bishop Namanya from Northankole, Bishop Komeko Mitiana, Bishop of Ruero Nsuga, Bishop Dr. Sheldon Mesigwa, this one, from Ankole, Bishop Magezi Amos from Northwest Ankole, Bishop Nelson Baruku from South Rwenzori, this one from West Ankole, Bishop Johnson Tuomo Jr., Bishop Naimane Busoga, Munat Sangaire, Bishop Karamaja, Joseph Abra, Mata. And this one,
Provincial Dean and my brother bishops, the clergy, and all of you brothers and sisters in Christ, praise the Lord. Your Grace, thank you for inviting me to join in this wonderful celebration of our 60th year of celebration as a self-governed church. In the spirit of the East African revival, of which I'm a product, I have a confession. On Christmas Eve, 1974, as a young man, I gave my life to the Lord Jesus Christ. And I still love the Lord because he has loved me, and I have loved to serve him over the years. Sadly, I fell into sin of adultery, and I confessed to the Lord to forgive me. And I want the church to forgive me, my brother bishops, all our partners, brothers and sisters in the vineyard of the Lord, the entire Church of Uganda, and all our partners all over the world. and the family of Reverend Christopher and his wife Judith, the two families, please forgive me. And I want to remain closer to Jesus, and I want to hide my life on the unshakable rock. Ninajificha kwenye mwamba usiotingizika. I want to continue on that solid rock. So, my life is focused on eternity because the worldly things will end, but one day I will stand before the Lord to give accountability of what I did in this world. And that is more important for me than anything else. So, I thank the Lord for loving me, and I will continue serving him until he calls me home. Praise the Lord.
Listen to the word of God. 1 John chapter 1, verse 8.
I'll ask some of these questions. What happened in 1961, if I was to ask those of you who are here, who were present, some of you were present, but you may not know what happened. What happened is that hitherto we were called Native Church of England. And some of us belonged to that Native Church of England. In our prayers, where we pray for the head of state, we are praying for the Queen. And we had crammed all those names and titles. I was passing in Kororo yesterday, and I saw some of the streets named after the Queen of that time, who is still present, her husband who recently died, their sons and daughters in Kororo there. The names are there. It reminds you, we have some attachment we have had for quite some time. But in 1961, we were independent to being Church of England, to being Church of Uganda.